Good morning friends. Today I'll be demonstrating you how to make a Adam's clasp. It's also called as a universal clasp since it can be made on any tooth. Explaining the armamentarium, what we require is a fairly straightened 0.7 mm stainless steel wire, a universal plier, half round plier, a heavy wire cutter and a marker pen. So this is the fairly straightened stainless steel wire and this is the tooth number 4-6 where we will be preparing our Adam's clasp. Now the first thing we have to decide is the length of the horizontal arm of the Adam's clasp. There are two school of thought. Either it could be the intercuspid distance or 2/3 of the mesiodistal width of the tooth concerned. So I'll take it as a roughly 2/3 of the mesiodistal width. Now I have to give this bend. Our final aim is these bends should be 90 degrees, but trust me, there are a lot of bends we have to still give, so it's always better to make it as a V like this. Now we have to decide the height of the Adam's clasp, which is roughly at the 1/2 of the, or let's say exactly at the half of the cervico-occlusal length. So I'll be marking the length of my Adam's height, let's say height of the Adam's clasp, and I give a bend. This is what decides the height of my Adam's clasp. Now after deciding the height of my Adam's clasp, I need to give the arrowhead bend. This is something you need to very carefully see. I hope it gets focused well. I'll be holding this at this edge of my plier. Hold it tight and give it a bend like this. I'll show it on the other side as well. Hold it tight at this part of the Adam's plier. Give it a hold it very tight. You need a good plier for this step and do it like this. Now, since my height is decided, I have started working on my arrowhead bends. One thing you have to know is this angle of the horizontal arm with the tooth should not be straight, should not be very flat, it should be 45 degrees. This angle should be 45 degrees like this. Now at this stage kindly see what next we have to do is we have to bend this arm outside like this, and the thing is this will be exactly half of this dimension. So on this wire I'll hold it like this, watch it very closely, I'll try to do it slowly, I'll bend it like this and this. I'll show it on the other side. I'll hold it in the half, bend it like this and like this. And to give that famous $1 million bend, this needs to be 45 degrees in this plane as well. I'll explain you. I'll hold it again at the middle and bend it like this. Can you make out? This angle has become 45 degrees. Same thing has to be applied on the other side like this. This gives me a 45 degree here and a 45 degree here. Now giving a tip to you. Now since now we have to start adapting the Adam's clasp on the cast, I'll recommend marking two dots on the cast where your arrowhead touches. Because if at every step you keep on changing the position of the Adam's clasp, one time you keep it like this, one time you keep it like this, your Adam's clasp is never gonna get settled. So wherever your arrowhead's clasp are touching the gingiva, mark two dots here so that this position becomes reproducible. And remember, this angle will always remain 45 degrees. Okay. Now starting with the adaptation part, keeping this angle at 45 degree and making my arrowheads contact the gingiva at the desired location, I'll start adapting one of the tag arm. Now this has to be done when you see the cast occlusally. If you can see, I have adapted this arm, but this arm is going way outside the contact area. So I'll make a tag here and I'll bend it little inwards using my half round plier. A half round plier always makes your bendings lot easier. Now if you can make out, it has started falling on the occlusal embrasure, and just like any other clasp, I'll give it a bend here. Showing the same thing on the distal tag arm, if you can make out, I have made a bend here. I've made a mark here, and I'll bend this along with the embrasure using my half round plier. And I'll check whether it's falling with the embrasure. Yes, it is. So after adapting both the tag arms, this is how your Adams will almost look like. The things your instructor will look into is this arm should be at the half of the cervical occlusal length. These angles should be 45 degree and well adapted tag arms. I would have loved to have these bit longer, provided more sulcus was recorded in this cast. Since Adam's clasp is a passive component of a removal orthodontic appliance, it should never be active. And how the passivity of a component is checked is, it should fall once you evert your cast.